Hi everyone, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're looking at the Rockwood 2604Ws. This particular Rockwood 2604WS is the new 2007 features versus the old 2017 features. One of the things that you can tell the difference between the old 17 and the new 17 is they have newer decals that have like a maroon in them, as well as a ton of features on the inside, as well as this one has a window on the front instead of a rock guard on the front for the front window. So that's how you can tell the difference between the two. The other thing that you'll really like about this particular floor plan is it has two nice chairs in the back that swivel and rock, as well as a separate bedroom up front. It has two slide outs, a super slide where both the couch and the dinette is in one slide out, and then a wardrobe slide in the front bedroom area. Some outside features to show you. One, we have a power awning on this guy, LED lights through the top, outside speakers, frameless automotive style windows, outside grill, a table that comes here. You can pull the TV out here and hang it right here, and it's on this nice swivel mount. This has a quick connect for the barbecue grill so that you can get propane to it very easily. It also has a cable outlet out here so that you can plug in your TV antenna as well as 110 power. Another nice thing is this has a really good clearance. It has the aluminum rims versus the white painted rims. That's another thing that they've changed. So they used to have a emerald, sapphire, diamond package. They've done away with all that, and a lot of that stuff has gone into the units as standard now instead of as an optional feature. These are the nitrogen filled tires. You can tell that by the little green valve stem. That means that they're going to have better handling, longer tread life, improved fuel economy, as well as a smoother, quieter ride. The torsion suspension that's also on this unit gives you a lot of independent suspension, so things aren't bumping around nearly as much in your camper compared to like a leaf spring suspension. This also has the oyster color to it, which is an option, as opposed to the white fiberglass, so it gives it a little bit more flair. You'll notice it has two large grab assist handles and two entry doors with three steps up instead of two steps up, which is needed on a unit like this because of the extra height that you get and the extra clearance that you get on this unit. This is also, the power awnings have a little knob right here that you can adjust to adjust the awning that covers both doors, I should mention. So it's almost the entire length of the camper. And you can adjust the rain so it funnels off this way or that way so that it's not drizzling in your camp spot. You'll notice that this has a huge amount of storage underneath here, all aluminum structure, as well as a light in here so you can see what you're doing. Handles for overrides for everything from slide outs to your power tongue jack to your electric stabilizer jack. So it's just a push button to get those to go up and down. This also has the solar port on it. So if you wanted to plug in like a solar panel that we sell in our parts department and put it outside, you can be able to do that. This also, and this is the front cap/window that I was telling you about. So instead of a rock guard that you have to flip up, which is kind of hard to reach anyway, and it had the little aluminum brackets that sometimes got bent in heavy wind, this guy is just a normal piece of window. So most of your rocks are going to be up in this area anyway, so they've made a strong enough window so it's less likely to have to worry about breaking. It also has nice LED lights on the front here, as well as an LED light here. There's a little light switch right here to turn these guys on and off. Two buttons, one is for the light on the front of this guy, as well as up and down motion here. And then there's a little rubber port that you can pull this cap off and then put a crank in there if you need to crank this guy up and down. Two 30 pound tanks instead of two 20 pound tanks underneath here. That has the easy access from the top to switch from one tank over to the other. It also has the auto changeover regulator, so it will switch from one tank to the other automatically for you. This front cap is a type of material called TPO. If you were to take a sledgehammer to this guy, it will flex and you might be able to dent it, but you won't be able to crack it like you would like a normal fiberglass. This also will not fade over time because instead of having a coating, it's that color all the way through, so it won't oxidize like a lot of other campers will out there. This hot water heater is a gas electric DSI hot water heater. So what that does is it can run off both the gas and the electric at the same time. The gas, you just push a button on the inside to turn it on and off. The electric, there's a little on-off switch right here, and you can push this button to make the electric side turn on and off. If your hot water heater stops working, there is a reset button right here. You just push this button and reset it. It's your T-stat and ECO is what those are behind here. And after a while, if you have to reset that so many times, you can replace that and just unscrew that and put a new one in. This also has an anode rod in it, or a sacrificial rod. So you would just unscrew that. And you wanna unscrew that to let out all the water in the tank inside here. And what that does is it makes it so that your water doesn't sit in there stagnant for several weeks while it's in storage. This also has the antifreeze inlet port here. The nice thing about this is if you need to winterize your coach, there's a valve right behind here, and you turn that and you can hook up a hose right here into your jug of antifreeze and turn on your water pump and then suck all the antifreeze through your lines. It's RV antifreeze that you want to use. A higher level of polypropylene or some kind of lubricant helps make it so that your valves don't dry out, whereas alcohol will dry it out. So make sure you use a high-grade antifreeze when you're winterizing it. But this makes it way easier. Instead of having to take apart your water pump to do all that, you just hook up to this, turn a valve behind there, and you're set. This is your fresh water and city water connect. And then back here, I don't know if you can see it, but there is a canister. And what that is your fresh water filter. So it filters all the water that goes into your unit up to 10,000 gallons. And it's residential grade, filters down to 0.9 micron. This also has the hot water and cold water for your outside shower, as well as the little button right here to turn on and off. Cable satellite hookups both are right here, as well as a black tank sewer flush. So this has little sprayers built into your sewer tank, and it sprays out your tank for you instead of having to drag a hose into your camper, down the toilet, and then cleaning it that way. Another storage area right here. This is underneath the dinette, so you can access this area from the inside or the outside. The other side of the dinette has a pull-out drawer, so you don't have access to it here, but it makes it nicer to be able to, if you have some things that you get in and out all the time, you can do that. Back here you have the 30 amp plug-in. This does have the little LED light because it's from Furion, and it makes it so that you can tell if you have power going to the coach or not. Along with that is the Furion backup camera port as well, so it can easily fit a backup camera right into that slot, and it's a super easy plug-and-play system. If you decide to go with that option, it doesn't come with that, but comes with the spot for it. You'll also notice this has the nice hard-shelled spare tire cover as opposed to the soft shell one that gets ratty after usually about a season or two. This has the window, bonded window, but also the ladder so that you can access the top of your roof. The reasons why you'd want to get up there is, one, if your slide outs are out and you get some stuff on them or water on them, you want to be able to clean that off before you put your slide out in to protect your membrane, as well as make sure that there's not like pine cones and sticks and stuff like that and water getting into your coach. This does have a one-piece TPO Superflex Alpha roof membrane that has a 12-year warranty on it. It chocks less than a rubber roof, as well as more resistant to abrasion. So that's all the features on the outside. Let's go take a few looks at some of the stuff on the inside. So inside the 2604WS, there's a few features I wanted to show you in here as well. I wanted to also mention to you before we get too far carried away is we do have financing for everybody. We can get just about anybody financed. As we've gotten scores as low as 525 financed before. We also work with all the national lenders out there, so can find really competitive rates for you guys who have really high credit scores. But let's carry on for some of the features on the inside. These guys did a few changes on here. One, you'll notice the countertop has some speckles in it instead of the plain white countertop, so it gives it a little bit more depth. As well as they've gone to a different sink style than before, a little bit deeper, I would say, and a little bit different sink faucet as well. Another change that they've made is they've given you a little bit more room back here to work with. So the chairs aren't quite as boxy as before. You'll notice that these are nice and rounded instead of the old kind that were squared last month. And yeah, they still swivel back and forth and rock. And you can still pick them up and take them wherever you want. They are a little bit heavy. Let's see, some other changes that they've made. This is their new Jasper color. So they have stitching that is kind of like that baseball stitching look to it. I really like the color on this. I don't know how it will turn out on the video. They've also, on this particular one, made some nice looks to the, I don't know what you call this, the backing for this guy. It looks pretty nice. Some features just in general about this particular coach. One, it still has the day-night shade. So this is your night shade down. This is your day shade or your privacy shade, and then up, of course. This has the barreled roof on it. You can kind of tell where it's barreled based on this cabinetry, how it's laid out. You'll notice all this is the raised panel cabinetry throughout here. Another thing is your control panel monitor for your battery, how much fresh water, black water, and gray water you have on this guy, your light switches, your slide-out switches, your awning switches, all that's controlled from right here. Oh, and this is kind of cool too. They've put the electric heater button on the inside, whereas they used to do it on the outside only. So now you can control that from in here as well, which is kind of nice. And then it also has tank heaters on it. So these have 12-volt heated tanks, fully enclosed underbelly to protect you for some of that colder weather if you guys are doing that kind of deal. This couch does turn into a bed if you want it to use it as a bed, as well as the dinette turns into a bed. And then inside here, you have, this is the water filtration filter that goes into the canister. They also have a paper towel holder in here, a little spatula, as well as a towel bar. And they don't put those on from the factory because they want to let you kind of pick and choose where those go. We can help you install that. It's usually just a couple screws, or you can put it on yourself. This table is also movable. So if you decide to use it as like a picnic table outside, you can take this outside with you or put it in front of your couch or in front of your recliners, however you want to use it. And it's easy because it has a little button right here that you can pull, and it just slides down in position to turn it into a bed. As we continue on, I'll point out that this has the quick cool system on the AC. So you can open up these little gates here and dump all the cold air here, as well as you can open and close all these vents right here, as well as they're movable. So if you wanted to point all the cold air to one spot, you can. So if you wanted everything closed except for just at your recliners, two vents blasting cold air at you, you can do that. This has lots of counter space. So this is an extension countertop. So this is placed on here, but you can take that off, as well as you'll notice this is flush. So if you needed extra counter space there, you have it to work with. And then same with the countertop here for above your range. So it's a nice glass countertop that's flush. And then you have a knife rack in the back. And then when you have it folded up, it makes for a nice backsplash. And then you do have a little bit bigger oven than a lot of guys have in there. The competitors have an oven about half that size. This comes with all the Furion soundbar and TV that's movable to outside. The cool thing about Furion is they are one of the few, not all TV brands are built the same, especially for the RV world. So this has, you know, high definition and things like that, but it's also got climate smart built into it and vibration smart. So if you're going to leave your TV in over the winter, this can handle some more extreme temperatures than a lot of other electronics out there, as well as you can imagine some electronics are not made to be bumping down the road, and this guy is. So these guys are specifically going after the RV market, trying to be RV friendly, and that's what they've done. This also is the iRV Technologies radio system, specifically built for RVs, where you can control it for the outside speakers or the inside speakers or both. It has SD card slots, so if you're taking pictures with your camera and you wanted to pull the SD card out, you can plug it right here and see all your fun videos and pictures that you took during the day. It also has an HDMI port, as well as a DVD player, video in, audio in. The cool thing about stereos, it has all those features, but if you don't know how to use that stuff, it's worthless to you. They are including for you a nice little sheet to kind of explain how to do all the basic functions on there, with the question and answer built into your coach so that it can get you started, which is super helpful. You'll notice also these are all LED lights, and they're the nice soft LED lights. They're not very harsh like a lot of the competition is. They will run a lot cooler, so they're not fighting your air conditioner. They will use a lot less battery, about a tenth of the power that a normal incandescent light will use, and they're a lot brighter than a normal incandescent light. So that's all the features here. And then I should mention that the refrigerator is also gas electric. So you can run this off 110 power, and it will auto switch over to the gas side if it's not plugged into a coach. This has the automatic refrigerator, so you can set the temp right here digitally, as opposed to the little sliding bar that you have to set on the other kind. The handles, they just pivot at the top and bottom here to make it a lot more user-friendly compared to the kind that you have to like push a button to open up the deal. As we go into the bathroom, you'll notice that I have plenty of arm space to move around, and I have a nice skylight, so I have some natural light as well as plenty of headroom in here. I'm just under 6 foot tall. This has a large basin sink, so you can get both hands in there and wash your face or whatever without having to get water everywhere. I've used the smaller sinks and they're not nearly as friendly as this guy. It does come with the medicine cabinet as opposed to just the piece of glass on a wall, as well as toothbrush holder, towel holder, and soap holder, and another towel bar right here, which a lot of times those things are missing in campers, which are kind of important. It does have a 110 outlet below the sink, as well as you'll notice I have plenty of room to sit around and do paperwork if I need to. It has the max air fan up here with the cover over the fan, so it can pull a lot of air through this coach up to a 10 mile per hour breeze by opening up a window and turning that fan on. With that cover going over, one, it protects you from having to replace your vent lids from hail, as well as if you accidentally left it open and a rainstorm came in and soaks everything, you're not going to soak the entire camper with that. This does have a pocket sliding door here, so this guy pulls across. This has a TV backer built into the wall right here, so if you do decide to put another TV back here, you have all the connections as well as somewhere to mount it that's going to have some solid stuff behind it. And then this is a very deep wardrobe slide. So this slides in while you're traveling down the road, and you can see you have lots of good closet space to work with. Another cool feature is this is a Serta mattress, as opposed to like your normal entry-level mattress. This has the this is 460 Certaflex EX innerspring. They have the offset coils to protect you where the sides start to give out over the years. These ones have coils built into it, so it makes it a little bit nicer on the edges of this mattress, as well as throughout the middle of it too. This has the 12-volt outlet, as well as USB port and 110 outlet, all built into the side of your deal here so that you can throw your cell phone and keys and whatever else. And then it does have bedroom speakers in here too, so you can control the living room, soundbar speaker, the bedroom speakers, or the outside speakers, all from that stereo system. And then over here is a little bit more space for to hang up more clothes. And then above here, you can see there's more storage. And then the AC is ducted all the way through. And you have not only a window, but a full door with a screen door on it in the back as well, so that you have two entries and exits in case you need to get out of here in a hurry for fire reasons or whatever. One last feature I wanted to show you on the outside is this does have the friction hinge door. So you open it up a certain way, and then if wind's blowing on it, it's not gonna be slamming it back and forth like a lot of the other ones. And it's upgraded from the gas strut kind. The gas strut was a great idea for a while, but it only lets the door open up so far, which was kind of annoying to some people. So the friction hinge door, nice upgrade that Rockwood's doing now. So thanks for joining me on the Rockwood Ultralight 2604WS. Again, my name is Mate. We're here in the Great Outdoors RV in Evans, Colorado. Our phone number is 970-313-4337, or you can reach us on the web at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thanks, guys.